Hey, man, grab those keys.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with... Ah! All right, then, that's that. Goddamn. We should get going. You got the keys, so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Come on, Lincoln, we're burning daylight. Let's go, man. The clock's ticking. We get a move on. Let's go. Goddamn, that gets me every time. Let's go, man. The clock's ticking. How long you gonna carry him around? We need to get... That guy out for a week! Come on, Lincoln, we burning daylight.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses.
The old man wanted us to keep one of the guards alive, help throw the feds off the trail.
Like you said, I take a chance. Besides, if I learn anything from being over in Nam, someone's willing to flip sides once, they're probably willing to do it a second time. Fuck you in the process.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh? So come on, you gonna answer the question or what?
We on the coast of Quang Nai, evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting him onto a medical ship, and this woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand, and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops it.
Watch out!
Where was I? She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone to...
What the fuck you doing?
There they are. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were gonna tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, God damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. Conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day, you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day, everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better been one delicious fucking pig.
Dodge at the result. You're gonna attract the cops. Anyway, guards at the reserve probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat. Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
Where the hell you going, Lincoln? Now, here we go.
Put your IDs up the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
The fuck's this shitheel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet. You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills, mostly.
I'll let Miss Gale call up to your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
Boy, pull your head out and grab that money. Need to check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying rooms down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
Yeah, my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job, and any old nigga who staggers in is hired on the spot. You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you! Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
Yeah, Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. Yeah, it doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are. Those bags on the table there.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
I guess the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck. That's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy come around the house trying to switch me over to oil. Told him I wasn't interested.
I never was neither till I saw this. At least...
God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
All right, give me a second. All right, you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
We've been renting now. Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell it. Told them they needed to be out in 2 weeks. And the man, his name's John, starts laying into me. Huh? Come on, we need to get this vault open.
Jesus Christ, it's a fucking rock! Got me stuck!
It's just a sign that you're pulling your brain!
Gonna blow his damn head off. Let's get those.
Goddamn, we sure kicked the hornet's nest this time.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapon stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this. Fuck! Fuck! Come on, open!
Give me that damn thing.
With the smoke!
Shit, man, these guys ain't fucking around.
Faced way worse than this over in Nam. A little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
Got an officer down. He's right there. He's right there.
So Sammy's doing all right?
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets.
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say, sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than three words, and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses, and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got...
Hey, man, be careful.
Yeah, anyway.
Fuck it, it's your car. Bash it up all you want.
Yeah, anyway. Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, that was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he can keep his old man from fighting out. We'll steer clear of the Hollow in Frisco, just selling the French wall. Georgie's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. George is a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a three-way split.
I don't know. I kind of need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah. Damn, you're scratching the paint. Anyhow, like I was saying, come on, we're going through the front. I ain't having your wall here. I ask who's the back door.